Welcome to our channel IAM Technocrats. Hey, this is Priya. Our first section in the course roadmap was what is identity and access management or IAM. The second section was the why, how, who and what of IAM. The third section in the course roadmap was our approach to IAM. Finally, in this last section, let's discuss IAM tools. Before we wrap up the session, it is important to discuss how an IAM project would look like or what tools you would need. Exactly, talk about these important topics. We need to develop a strategy aligned with the business needs and consider people, processes, and technology issues. As discussed earlier, don't think of IAM as an IT-only initiative, especially when it addresses business usage and the regulatory requirements. You should be strategic, not tactical, when planning and designing a solution. Because IAM is pervasive, be prepared for objections and concerns during any transformation process. Before we wrap up this session, it is important to discuss how an IAM project would look like or what tools you would need. Exactly, talk about these important topics. We need to develop a strategy aligned with the business needs and consider people, processes, and technology issues. As discussed earlier, don't think of IAM as an IT-only initiative, especially when it addresses business usage and the regulatory requirements. You should be strategic, not tactical, when planning and designing a solution. Because IAM is pervasive, be prepared for objections and concerns during any transformation process. The time to transform an IAM program is right after you have considered the IT trends, evaluated the capabilities, and identified business drivers. The success of an IAM transformation depends on the interaction of people, processes, and technology. When integrating people, process, and technology, organizations can be inundated by technology options. Check out the considerations on screen.
Times. Appoint experienced team members on the project and ensure that the client had dedicated and engaged staff to support the effort, because it takes a long time to become skilled in IAM methodologies, control implementation, process re-engineering, stakeholder alignment, and program and change management. Times. Use a risk-based and business-centric approach. Consider the downstream impact on organization structure as well as key stakeholders, so that any IAM enhancements can progress smoothly and with minimal disruption of business. Times. Be proactive in establishing ongoing support by designating an experienced operational manager. Times. Avoid confusion and contention over priorities by appointing one executive-level owner who is empowered to make decisions as required. Times. Document access control processes and perform periodic testing to validate that processes are being followed. Times. Inform key stakeholders early that business processes will have to change to accommodate the improvement of IAM capabilities. Temper that message with the fact that IAM can simplify processes by eliminating manual, error-prone access management procedures, including access requests, approvals, and reviews. Times. Configure and, if required, customize IAM products to meet IAM requirements that are unique to the organization. Times. Define priorities of the client organization to select the technologies that best support their needs. Times. Add descriptions to entitlements as a key activity in transformation programs. Use business-friendly definitions that avoid technical jargon.
Into the business drivers we've just discussed. Organizations need a framework to manage their IAM program. We have developed a comprehensive framework of functions and aspects which need to be covered. We call it framework because it covers all the bases of IAM. It helps as a structure when talking with the client, when investigating the current situation of IAM in an organization, and when writing reports and proposals. We can locate all the parts of IAM in the framework across the entire program. You will learn that governance, including policies and standards, compliance and oversight, is key to supporting the framework. It provides the processes and authorization mechanisms that are used to maintain control over data and security. This includes governance of the data itself and the technology used to manage it. Identity and credential layer shows the processes associated with identity management access that we discussed previously. Each user will ideally have one digital identity. In typical cases, users have several digital identifiers. On the other hand, each application and system may have different credentials, including passwords, certificates, attributes, and tokens. These are necessary to authenticate and then authorize the user. Access or access controls are those functions that act as gatekeepers for the applications and databases. We also speak of access control enforcement because these functions apply rules and guidelines to permit or disallow users from reaching into business data assets. Authoritative sources represent different potential sources of information about users and access in an organization. User data is generally created in the HR database or using other forms of user registration. The authoritative data sources are those where the users are created first and under strict controls. It is assumed that the data and resources will be of high quality and will be maintained according to appropriate standards. Finally, administration and intelligence provide user administration. For example, when users join the organization or leave, system administration must follow security guidelines and user administration principles to keep the organization safe.
Thanks for the detailed overview, Priya. This framework will guide each project writing to adopt the format and the content. Of course, the terminology may be different depending on the client. Given the business drivers we just discussed.
IAM tools. As Manish mentioned, how the IAM framework fits in different organizations can vary with how they address the categories. For example, an organization may be good at access settings, but may not have a strong governance process in place to handle the overall IAM program. Here are some of the IAM tools which are market leaders. Identity Governance and Administration Tools. SailPoint Identity IQ, SailPoint Identity Now, Savint IGA, Omada Identity, Omada Identity Cloud, One Identity Identity Manager, IBM Security Verify, ForgeRock Identity Platform, Microsoft Identity Manager. Access Management Tools. Okta, Microsoft Azure AD, Ping Identity, OneLogin, ForgeRock OpenAIM, CyberArk AIM. Privilege Management Tools. CyberArk Privileged Access Manager, BeyondTrust Password Safe, OneIdentity Privileged Access Management, Delinea Secret Server.
Finally, let's take a look at all the essential processes managed under IAM Solutions, IAM Needs, and what benefits can be achieved by implementing. Essential processes managed under IAM Solutions. Onboarding processes, hiring, onboarding, job mobility, termination. It includes provider employees, contingent workers and vendors. IAM processes, access request and approval, provisioning and deprovisioning, access enforcement. It includes standardized self-service request and approval portal, increased automated access management to applications, hosts, databases, clouds and mobile devices, access policies defined and enforced secure access, authentication and authorization. Risk processes. Risk analysis. It includes access certification and monitoring, risk-based access certification, SOD analysis scan, elevated user activity, SOD violations and user access anomalies.
IAM needs. Identity and access management needs, job roles, risk analysis, standardized access profile, and strong access control. Benefits of implementing identity and access management tools. Streamlined compliance, automated controls to reduce risk, efficient certification, business intelligence reporting, 360-degree visibility, auto-provisioning, reduced costs, user-centric and user access profile-driven, single source of identity, and many more.
Now let me wrap up the content of the four modules you have completed. In the first module, we defined the terms identity and access, reviewed the associated tasks, and also listed the difference between them. In the second module, we learned about why IAM is essential, how to address IAM, who is involved, and what technologies and processes are needed to avoid risk. Next, we discussed how IAM fits within the broader IT picture and overview of security services, the cybercrime threat, and the factors to consider for successful collaborations between companies and systems. In the final module, we talked about IAM tools.
At last, I would like to thank you on behalf of our channel IAM Technocrats to view and learn our course. Do like, share and subscribe to stay tuned to learn more. Please share your feedback in comments section. You can also write us at iamtechnocrats@gmail.com or message on Instagram at @iamtechnocrats. You can follow us on Instagram as well at @iamtechnocrats.